By now, you should be getting a hang of how to use SolidWorks. And believe it or not, just the little tips that we've given you so far is enough to get you started on building your invention. Let's continue and learn something new about assemblies. Remember, we go File, New, Part, check our units, options, document properties, units. We're gonna do inches, hit okay. And today I'm actually gonna build a couple of parts and then we're gonna put them together in assembly. It's not gonna be anything fancy, just to show you that you can easily make assemblies and test the fit of all your parts. So let's get started. Let's pick the top plane, right click. And we're gonna do something different. Let's make what looks like a bolt. So here we are. Remember to dimension. And we'll give it a half inch head. Because this is a pentagon, you can see that it needs one more side defined in order to keep from spinning. We're locked on the origin and we have a dimension, but you can rotate it. So all we have to do is go up to relations, add relation, and pick one of the lines, and we'll just say that that one's vertical. Now you can see the part is locked because you can't spin. Once we do that, we will extrude it. And again, you should know this by now. And we'll do 1/4 inch. Let's do 375. Oh, and one thing I should show you. Math works in most of the dimension boxes. So instead of doing 375, I could do something like, let's just say 3/8. 3 divided by 1/8 or 3/8. And it'll automatically change it to 375. If I do, it doesn't matter what we do, 4 divided by 8, 0.5. So let's put it back to 3/8. Let's say we wanted to subtract 1/8. We could just do minus 0.125 and it'll automatically calculate it. So that's a good little trick to know. But let's get back to our bolt. So we'll do 0.375. And we're gonna select that surface, put a circle, and dimension it. We'll make it 3/8 or 375. And we'll extrude it. And we'll make it 1 inch long. I'm not going to get into showing you guys how to do threads or anything like that. There are plenty of tutorials on YouTube that'll show you how. So now we need to take this bolt and save it. Just call it bolt. Next thing we need to do is open a new part. So we go back, file, and you can open multiple parts while SolidWorks opened. The other one is still here. It's just down at the bottom. You can select it and go back to it. Right now we're gonna work on the nut. So we'll do top plane. We can do front plane, whatever you want, but I'm gonna do top plane. Again, we're gonna select the hexagon, open it up. We need to dimension, so we'll pick our dimension. I remember it was a 1/2 inch bolt. And just like the last part, we also need to add relation. And we'll make that vertical. Now we're locked. And we'll extrude it. Oh. Now see, now something that I forgot to do. So what we need to do is we need to go into options, and this is a good way to look at our mistake. First, what we need to do is go back into the sketch. Just exit out and I'm gonna go back in, edit sketch. Cause that is 0.5 millimeter. I didn't notice that. So we'll do 0.5 and then you can also type in inches. and it'll automatically know that you want to do inches. But then we must go up to Options, Document Properties, Units, Inches. Okay, so now we're going to go to Features, Extrude at Base, and 0.5 inches this time again. Now we need a hole. So we'll put a hole through the center. Now we select that origin, go here. We're gonna do 3/8 again, or 375. But this time we're gonna go Feature, Extrude to Cut. And we'll do through all. A word on parts, there are two ways of doing this. If you make the hole exactly the same size as the bolt that's gonna go through it, in the real world, it won't fit. It will here in Solidworks, but it depends on what you're doing. If you are actually building parts for a machine shop or 3D printer, you're going to need to compensate. So we can go back in and just add a little bit of tolerance so that the bolt fits through this nut. So let's do that. So we go back into Cut Extrude. We open up the sketch by opening the folder up, right-clicking, hitting Edit, and instead of 0.375, all we have to do is make this 0.38, I should say, 0.375, adding 5 thousandths. And there we go. And that should give us just a little bit of room. If we were worried, we could even take it to 0.85 to give us even more tolerance. And then we'll save this part, and we'll save it as none. Now this is the neat thing about SolidWorks. We can actually test to make sure these two parts fit. So let me show you how to do that. We want to go new again, but this time we're going to choose assembly. Hit OK. So to begin the assembly, the first thing we want to do is we want to bring in the bolt. And there it is. Now, you need this, if you do not lock it in, if you just hit OK, it'll move around on the screen. So what we need to do is we need to lock it to the origin. The easiest way to do that is just drag your mouse over this area over here on Begin Assembly and then hit OK. Now this part is locked in the screen. So we have our bolt and we can go back to Assembly and then we're going to select Insert Component and we're going to select Insert Nut. And here's our nut. And we're just going to select somewhere out in space because what we're going to do is what's called mate. We're going to select mate. We're going to select this circle and we're going to select this circle. And as you can see now, they're lined up. And interestingly enough, we're able to rotate it around. If we wanted to mate this so it didn't move, we could add two more mates. We could say here, and it'll keep those two parallel. And in addition, we can select this and this edge, and it'll lock it in permanently. But now the problem is you're not able to test to see if it works. And if we zoom in, you can see that our tolerance is quite wide. We're not going to worry about that now, but you can adjust it if you wanted to make it a tighter fit. But let's back out of our two mates. The one mate was able to remove, but you can see I still can't spin it. So what we can also do is we can go into a couple of places. We can go into the mates in the tree here, or we can go into the mates up in the individual parts. So we'll just find the one, and as you can see easily, it's this one. Just right click on it, showing you, and delete it. Yes. And now we're able to rotate. So this allows us to test to fit it apart. You can also, you can see that the part will go through. You can set boundaries if you want. We're not going to do that now. But let's do one more thing. You can go Insert Component, and we can pick another nut. And then what we could do is the same thing, hit Mate. And now we have two nuts that are sitting on the same bolt. So you can see that we need a little more rooms. One thing we could do is we could go to the bolt. After we close out of here, out of mates, we could right click on that, open part, and we could make this a little longer. We can right click on the extrude, edit feature, and we'll just make it 1.5 inches. Now we have some more room. If we go down here, you'll see that the assembly has automatically updated, and now we have more room for our nuts. Please tune in for our next episode of Learn SolidWorks in 5 minutes. Don't forget to subscribe.